first arrived, I couldn't believe it was the original airplane that I seen on these documentaries back during the war. And I thought, man, what a huge job this is gonna be. For a while, you really didn't see a whole lot of progress. And then all of a sudden, the airplane started to get bigger, the pile of parts were getting smaller. Then it was really becoming recognizable what it was. It's just coming together real nice now. If you mention B-17, the Memphis Belle pops into your mind. As famous as she is, as rare as she is, you know, when I was a kid, I seen pictures of her in magazines. Everywhere it landed, somebody carved their name into it, like graffiti. But then it appears here, and I get to work on it. I mean, how satisfying is that? To have that here in our possession and have it restored to what it looked like when it flew its last mission, it's like opening up a history book. Probably the most important thing to me is to see the veterans that come through here and to see the looks on their faces. You know, it was a short part of their life, but it was a big part of their life. You know, we've had veterans come through here with their families, and they'll see something back here and they'll start telling a story, and their wife will say, he's not ever talked about it like this before. It pulls something out and it takes them back in time. To me, that's what it's all about, to see these guys reliving a very important part of their life. You know, it's very important to preserve this stuff and to see it be put on display and people who enjoy it. I mean, these veterans aren't going to be around forever. These guys come through here and some of them go straight from the door to the bell. It's in a lot of people's hearts.